Hi, Bios. This is Rajesh K, signing on. Today's topic is NetCool Available Overview and its architecture. So let's get started. So in the first slide, it describes about the architecture of NetCool. The standard multi-tier architecture having 3 tiers, as you can see. And it could be questions, you could phrase the question like, is it possible to have single tier architecture and having all the components installed in one go, in one server? Yes, that's possible. For that, actually, you need to have figure out your capacity planning and chunk out your capacity planning, right? So it should have a more size and bandwidth for that. You need more RAM, more space, and more bandwidth to run all these components in one go and one server, right? So even 3-tier architecture as well required lots of capacity planning as well beforehand. So here we'll today we'll discuss on that, and depending even the first slide itself, the 3-tier architecture. So first is collection layer, second is aggregation layer, and third is display layer. So let me zoom a little so we can see properly. Yeah. So as you can see, the bottom one is number 1, middle one is number 2, and the last is 3, the top. So bottom panel is nothing but your collection layer. Middle layer is number 2nd, and that is consists of your aggregation layer. And third, the top layer is thingy display layer, right? So all the 3 layers accumulating and form as your 3-tier architecture, right? And the right hand most side the diagram is showing you all the ingredients, all the modules of NetCool, and how that can be connected with each other and cooking with each other to share information, right? So I'll get back on this after making you understand what exactly this figure is. So as I told you, the first one is collection layer. What collection layer does mean is that in the collection layer we do have pair of NetCool object servers, right? You can see this is call underscore P and this one call underscore B. So collection primary and collection backup or secondary, you can say, right? So both are two servers and object servers being installed, and then there's call P and call B, right? And also we do have ingestion gateway, like it's written C2A get P1, C2A get B1. So this is one ingestion gateway is running on the primary collection of servers. Where is your collection primary is running this server and this one call B underscore 1. This is one of the server, and the same server also one ingestion gateway is running. So two ingestion gateways, two of these servers. So this is primary and this is secondary, right? So individual unique directional gateway pushing the events from respective of the servers upwards to the counterpart of the servers in aggregation layer, right? So we could have one more pointer here, like probe servers, right? Let me draw that for you. Just one second. So let me describe you again. So this is my probe server getting somewhere, right? From this probe server, events is coming towards your collection of the servers, right? So this is raw data only, whatever data is coming from the probe, because probe always has the raw data only in non-readable human format, right? So once the raw data is placed on the probe server, and right now it's pointing to your collection pair of your servers. Now, in both are collection layer of the servers, but one is primary, one is secondary. On two boxes, EVSN gateway is also running, right? So, counterpart alerts from the call P primary goes up to your AGDP. AGDP is the primary aggregation layer, primary servers, and likewise, this call B, for the services running, the C2 gate B1, industrial gateway, is pushing these alerts from the service server towards the aggregation backup. So both industrial gateway pushing events from this primary and secondary of the server towards your aggregation primary and backup of the servers, right? Now, you can see there is a middle button here, middle picture. And this is nothing but your AGG gate. So right now, this AGG gate is functional as a failover pair, right? Or you can say it's a high availability and syncing the data between your AGGP and AGGP, right? So you might have a question like, what is bidirectional gateway and what is inversion gateway? Now, inversion gateway having one reader, one writer, and one paper. Whereas your bidirectional gateway having two writers, two readers, and two mappers, right? So it can write and read simultaneously. So exactly this gateway is something like that. So it's made a connection between AGGP and AGGB and sync the data in between, because both edge servers sending data through the investment gateway, right? So suppose anyone goes wrong, this server stop. So still, this server, investment gateway, continue to push this server, right? And this server is being connected to this server through the bidirectional gateway. In that way, it's both the servers synced. I hope you're clear on this. Okay, the data is traveled from here to collection layer, then collection layer to investment gateway is moved forward to your aggregation layer, second number, right? And right now the data is here. Now again it goes towards your display layer of the servers, display 1, display 2. Through the gateway only, investment gateway. So two investment gateway like your collection is there only. Its job is to pull data from this respectively and enough the data in display layer for this servers. Sometimes this total layer is not there, only you have USB or TVN list where you see the LS directly, right? In that module, USB module, you feed in your data source directly to this HGP or HGB. So the data comes directly from here to gateway rather than to display layer, right? So this is talk about your collection layer, aggregation layer and display layer. Display layer is something mean for your end users who are dedicatedly monitoring your infra servers 24/7. Maybe your commercial people, maybe DC ops team or AI ops team, whoever teams dedicated to monitoring this AEL view, a team analyst view, where all the alerts come and in-house in a central control, right? So this one, rightmost side, is the diagram, as I told you. This is showing all the connectivity from different modules towards the object server. So what is object server? Object server is nothing but in-house memory resident database system, where all the alerts, human readable alerts, are stored in a database format, and you see those data on the front-end panel, that is called object server. And to the object servers, various modules can be the data. For instance, here you can see this SNMP, simple network management protocol, kind of probe, SNMP probe, it's also sending the data, TL1, all the modules are sending data, right? Server monitors, right? So from the object servers, the data can be moved to different modules, maybe that can be route towards RDBMS, right? For future reference for your data to reporter ultimately. So reporter is the module of NetPool, like other modules lineup. So its main job is to keep reference of future data in a database. So anyone required information or reports in the future date, right? For instance, for example, real data is in-house in this server. Now one person came or organization need the reports today date, current time before 6 months. So in that case, if you have reporters server installed in and RDBMS obviously imposed on that, so you can have easily extract those data and make it report and send to your individual clients, right? For that purpose, you do have reported data here. Also, you can object server data, also you can move to your browser and make it visible to your individual or command center people. That is called AEL that I told, this layer. Also, data can be moved towards your trouble ticketing system, right? Suppose we are server saving 75 critical alerts. For those critical alerts, I need ticketing, and for that you need to have a gateway in place, functional gateway, remote gateway. then you can push those data through the gateway towards your double ticketing system, right? Like visionary portal in the sense your display portal, like maybe to see the alerts live, what is current alerts in the system, info alerts, likewise impact. So we think before reaching to the customers, individuals, we want to enrichment of alerts, that is in-house inside our servers. You can do that well through impact. So impact is nothing but your enrichment tool in Metro Omnibus, right? So all these modules are nothing but the additional softwares that come separately apart from Metro Omnibus, right? To make the structure or install the structure in your environment, you should have first capacity planning. You should check out the plan to load the object server core, Metro Omnibus core, right? So once you install the core, then you could have a module, this module installed to obtain the required functionality that these tools provide, correct? Go to next slide. Yeah, Jabberwocky NetCore synopsis. So I just try to beep out what I mentioned in the first slide, that synopsis for that. So NetCore is the brand name devised by Micromise, obviously known, which was acquired by IBM around 2006, and from that period it is understood as a NetCore suite of products, right? Its capability is robust and it's well recognized as a part management system and perhaps management system too. And the main advantage of network product suite is that they can manage devices on multi-vendor distributed networks and can maintain your network management system effortlessly. The entire product should have the patent imposed stability suite in market, right? So after the year 2006, Tivoli patented this entire network suite of products, and by then that is recognized as a Tivoli product. So these are the list of products, names a few, but more than that actually. So the list of products suites of network can be categorized as below. Omnibus itself is the core part of the system. You need to first install this one to get ready to explore the things beyond Omnibus. So you need to have this also first, Omnibus core. After that you need to have probes. So probe functionality is, it can connect to your individual devices, network analyst devices, and fetch the information directly from there. So different probes having different functionality. For example, suppose you need to have alerts from the Huawei devices. In that case, you need to have Huawei probe installed in your environment. Then only your probes can fetch the Huawei devices and get the data from there, right? Yeah. Precision ITNM. Probes will capture, Omnibus will capture details in subsystem slides. This is an ITNM, this is for your network discovery, and this tool discovers your network entirely and returns in a topological view. So it has more wider capabilities. I will cover this topic in a different view. Then number two, WebGUI, as I told you, this is display layer. WebGUI is something representation of a layer in one single pane of view, or even one single sign-on view, you can say. In a single pane of glass, you get all the layers in-house in one console. You can have a filter assigned, you can have a trigger assigned, you can have computers, and you can create views, you can create filters accordingly for users, or region wise, or certain criteria based on the requirement or demand. impact, let me tell you. Impact is nothing but the enrichment of alerts. When alerts reach to your console in object server, you can write policies and rules to enhance your alerts such a way. For example, you can enhance your alerts or enhance your alerts through impact, right, to propagating in service now. So we'll also cover this topic in detail in subsequent chapters. In my coming videos, not this video. This is for only overall overview of Comet Pro. Pro is your red reporter that I told you, right? Reporter. So, just a pictorial diagram I have attached here for your view. So, this is called manage domain, right? Let me zoom it. So this is manage view, this portion, so this is fault collection department, this is event consideration, and last one transition. So this is fault collection, in the sense it collects the raw data from different devices through its probe. And the probe is the main criteria in NetCloud Omniverse to acquire data from the raw devices. Only NetCloud devices, sorry. So this is ITNM for IP, DSCP. This is for database management or ITKM, like ITKM for Oracle or system monitoring or system performance monitoring. One of the tool in NetCloud, Tivoli. ITM, right. So empty traffic, you better know, this is SNMP probe, simple network management protocol. So it's recognized the SNMP V1, V2, V3 module that the network device understands. So it can communicate through that, and it can communicate to the port 161.162. Okay, so this one also I will cover in the later video, but this is for your knowledge only. Syslog, this syslog file that maintains throughout the systems, starting to end of your system, when you boot your system, when you end shut down your system, all the logs, all the events which is occurring inside your system being fitted into your syslog file, right? So that log also you can monitor through NetCloud Omniverse. TechProbe, NetIQ, SMC. So these are all fault collection panel probes, right? So all these modules, all these probes, sending events raw data to public server, which is in central place, right? This is the in-house tool of NetCloud Omniverse, in-house memory SQL database, in-memory SQL database, right? And from this server you can push data anywhere through the gateway, like here remedy gateway is there, so remedy gateway transfers the failures to remedy server for ticketing. Here you can use this pointing to reporter gateway functionality to push those alerts in the server towards reporting server for future reports. Historical database, you can say. Here obviously are pushing to the webtop for individual view, like TC ops or command center people use to view the alerts which is currently live, right? Real time alerts. And also it's moving to your pushing to event console native. It's pushing and TBSM for modules. View, service views, and top one is nothing but your presentation views. You can see from one aspect web based event consoles, right? Like AEL, webtop. Second, you are switching to your event consoles, service views, right? TVSM. So this is talk about your all the relevant modules from NetCool. Right? Go to next slide. What is NetCool for Minibus? Overview. So it is a system level management system, or service level management system you can say, or fault management system you can say, that collects enterprise wide event information from a wide variety of IT and network resources in real time. Right? It presents a consolidated view of this information to operators and administrators for monitoring and management. Tracks related events in a high performance in-memory database and presents information of interest to specific users via filters and views. Provides automation functions that can perform event processing of alerts. Alerts information can then be assigned to operators, passed to held-up systems, to log in a database, replicated to remote monitoring systems for consolidation, failover and escape purpose, used to trigger automatic responses to certain events. Okay. So, as you know, it is called also SM or fault management system. All the alerts present a consolidated view to the operators and who are viewers or have want to action on the alerts, like TCS or commercial people, for managing and monitoring of the alerts. For the alerts, it is showcased in the object server. You can have imposed filters or views for better prediction of the alerts that the users want to view or see. Provides automation functions that can perform intelligent processing of alerts, right? And alerts information can be assigned to operators, right? Directly can assign the alerts to somebody else, someone else you people. So you can do that as well. Pass to helpdesk systems, you can pass the alerts to any helpdesk. This group is made inside the view or groups, view or filter inside your technical system. And you can also pass the events to a group of users and users. Login in a database, right? You can log in a database, the alerts can log in a database. You can post the events, you can post the alerts to any third-party database like Oracle or something, or to a flat file, something like that. Replicated to remote omnibus system for consolidation, failover, etc. Yeah. Also, from one object server to different object servers or multiple object servers, you can pass on the events for consolidation or failover or etc. Right? You can also make it etc. And it also can be useful to trigger automatic response to certain events. Suppose the certain events that you want to act as email to particular groups of users, right? You can write a trigger, the last one I'm talking about. You can write a trigger in Omnibus, NetCool Omnibus, to send specific alerts. For example, you want to send major alerts, 784, to a group of users belongs to. Right, you can do that as well. Okay, so let's go to next slide. Yeah, NetCool Omnibus components. These are the Omnibus components. First is object server, then port, gateways, desktop tools, administration tools, WebView visualization component, and right hand diagram is showcased on that. This server for gateway distributors, all that I'll be capture the details in subsequent slides and I'll make you understand what goes exactly, right? So yeah, as you see there is two other server here. And this particular diagram is nothing but your failover configuration between the server strings. You can see this is Denko, which is one of the sellers, and Denko is one of the sellers, right? And between those, gateway is running. Right? This gateway functionality is to failover pair HA, intersecting with HA, because syncing data between this and this. Right? This must be bidirectional gateway. Now, this object server feed in data from the probe here running and monitors. Going to this probe, sending alerts to the local of this server, this one. Right? The monitors also send data to this other server. This probe sends data to this other server. Now, this object server data is being synced with this object server, Denko, through or by the bidirectional gateway. Now, this data also is made available to event list, where you can see a single sign-on view. All these alerts which travel from this probe to this subject servers are available here, event list, as a form of event readable format, right? And also the observer data is being pushed to your administrator view. Administrator is nothing but your inbuilt module of NetCloud Universe, where you can manage the entire NetCloud module infrastructure, right? That is called NetCloud Universe. And you can have SQL interface there, you can delete alerts, you can assign filter views, you can assign filter views for the SQL and have the capability to showcase alerts based on the SQL command. And also these are the servers. And also observer data is being pushed to another gateway for the ticketing system, helpdesk, right? And also through this gateway is pushing the observer data to one IDBMS, right? So this observer data is getting feeding from the probes on the first end, sending events to its internal module event list and universe translated. Also the observer data is being available to helpdesk people CRM through the gateway, dedicated gateway, and also through this gateway, RDBMS like Oracle gateway or JDBC gateway, something like that. From this gateway, through this gateway, the observer data is moving to finally to RDBMS, maybe Oracle as well, right? Or Sybase. So this diagram talk about that. So let's discuss this 6 points in detail in next subsequent slides. NetCloud Omniverse component template. NetCloud Omniverse is based on a 3-tier client server module architecture and is a core application of the code show. NetCloud Omniverse consists of 4 components, namely probes, Omniverse object servers, NetCloud Omniverse desktop, NetCloud Omniverse gateways. Probes collect events from existing network management system as well events messages from network devices, computing system, applications or legacy systems. The probe can normalize and feed this event data into the server and object oriented memory system into the database. In object server, the event data is deduplicated, correlated and associated with other event data. By migrating data in the object server through the desktop, users can design customized views of the data to monitor segments of the network or services respond the entire network. Gateway storing data to be shared between multiple servers for load balancing or failover facilities exported to common relational database management systems for approval service for historical service views or integrated with other applications such as remedies helpdesk application, right? The first point is talk about your model architecture is based on 3-tier architecture, right? And what are the components, main components, probes, Omniverse object servers, desktop, gateways, right? And the second point talk about your probes, what probe functionality is. Its probe functionality is to collect the raw data from the individual devices, network devices, and sending to object servers, and obviously nothing but your memory is a central database. That is object server. And third point to talk about, once the data is available, you can make piece of data in a segment and make itself available to certain users. Right? You can manipulate data inside of the server to desktop users. Desktop users can design the customized view. When data is available, you can assign users to customize views for them. You can customize what they can monitor. And for the services we can monitor, you can also customize. So that is the point to talk about. The last point to talk about between how the gateways act as a load balancer HA between your servers through your different gateways. Right? And gateway can be two types. One is the internal gateways that comes is pre-bundled with the network domain. Those are your ingestion gateway and the bi-directional gateways. Apart from that, you can have a dedicated aggregation gateways. For example, your JDBC, ODBC, ServiceNow gateway, Humility gateway. So all these are dedicated aggregation gateways that enable us to push the observable data to different CRM, different database, and object servers and flat files. Right? That is the point to talk about. Okay. So I'll cover one by one object server and flat spokes from this slide. So these six I will cover in subsequent slides that I told you. Well, let's go one by one. Object server. Now the object server is the master of the entire NetSQL suite. I told you this is the heart of the NetSQL suite. Object server is key element to Omniverse. So it is a key element. It is the primary component of the NetSQL Omniverse. So the object server is memory efficient database. It makes it extremely fast and able to cope with far more events versus enemies. It uses subset of SQL which is referred to as service SQL, right? So object server is known as in-memory resident database. Right? It kept information which travel from probe and in a database it's keep hold of all the information, right? That is called your in-memory database. And those database can be maintained, well maintained through its integrated SQL interface subset of commands that is available inside your NetSQL administrator window, right? Or you can directly log in the backend and you can maintain through your SQL commands, right? That is the point of the server. Generally, data is inserted into the server by probes and is viewed through whatever the user's mental list, right? So data is inserted into a server by probes, right? And ultimately it's seen in the single pane of glass view in one panel that is called your event list, the event list, or you can you can call it as a Omniverse event list or WebGUI or webcam. Once data is displayed in a server, it can be manipulated by tools and automation. Tools and automations are given as a response, ticketed SQL statements, these are run either manually by user or automatically when certain criteria are met, in this case automation, right? So when data is reached in object server through the probe, you can make an automation by itself or you can write some scripts or procedures to make action on it, right? That is the manual way. That is done by your tools, different tools inside your NetSQL Omniverse. And also make it automations automatically and does its job. For example, you right click on the event and send to some user, but you can also automate the same thing by right click trigger and same alerts came and same problem came. You can push those alerts directly to specific users or groups by writing procedure rules, right? So, that's the query. And that can be possible through tools and automation. Tools and automation can also insert and delete data from the server and they can both run command like line instance as well as SQL statements, right? So, tools and automations are two pillars using which you can insert and delete data from the object server database. and you can also utilize that. You can also do your automation, right? The other set of values two key features, one was correlation deduplication, right? So this is very crucial and most important point here in all this. Those are two key features. So it does the correlation deduplication. These two methods, these two parameters, you can say, or point, is very crucial and omnibus. Now, what is correlation? So correlation means the same similar kind of events which repeatedly travel from probes to your surface servers do not maintain individual alerts inside of the server. Rather, what you will do is that it recognizes similar set of events and make it group and passes one liner of an alert and make the tail implemented for all the references, right? For example, your network down alert. So network down alert come to the server 5 times for the same problem, right? So it's get correlated and make passes one alert only, network down inside of the server, and tally will be 5 because your problem occurrences is 5 times the same problem came from the source. So it's been tally count total is 5, but in summary description it will be 1 liner, network down, right? And what is deduplication? Deduplication means your problem and resolution counterpart problem resolution functionality and deduplicated. So your network down is come. Now network is off at the same time. So network off alerts come. So down alerts may be your 4 or 5 or 3 as per the severity defined problem alerts. And for the counterpart alerts, the resolution is the counterpart alerts, which is can be severity 0. So that is called as your clear alert. Now both this problem and correlate with your resolution alerts, right? That correlation is nothing but your deduplication, right? And this will continue. So it's talk about the same thing actually. It's memory resident database. It's associated and deduplicated all the memory alerts, and that can be manipulated through different associated filters and views or tools. They can automate that. It does have, as you said, does have the functionality for deduplication and correlation. It can correlate event objects with other event objects, make decisions on information, automate operator responses, and facilitate problem resolution, right? That is called your deduplication and correlation. The other server, which has been designed and optimized for handling large volumes of events messages, can process hundreds of programs per second and can collect data from multiple hosts concurrently. So just by having the widest robust facilities, it can handle large volumes of event data that comes with, right? It can automate, it can manipulate data as for your requirement. The other server actually also permits multiple authenticated users to view all the events throughout the enterprise. In addition, since one network fault can impact several locations in a distributed environment and can therefore trigger multiple events, the other server is designed to automatically duplicate repeated events so that network operators can easily identify root cause. Now, let's talk about correlation and integration. So repeated severity of alerts, repeated events come to your console several times. So without having individual alerts for the same problem, what is not that? It creates a single alert with the daily increment increase for that time. Right? So that is called your correlation. What is probes that already mentioned you? Probes are nothing but raw data collectors from network devices. Probes are primarily basic software interfaces that collect network event data. So this false elevation term, right? From elements in the network or from domain-based network management system. So-called duty is to connect to the devices, individual devices, elements, and pull the data from there. And the data is maintained through data only, right? This code can collect information presented from either management platform and devices. H1 view, for example, and spectrum, Cisco, Nebus, The probes can collect different information from different devices, right? But I told you, why devices, for example, or aware devices. So you can have a certain probe that can fetch the information from the devices and push the alerts to your office servers, right? So different probes have different functionalities. Like we have Cisco probes, Huawei probes, you have Spectrum, you have SNMP, you have Message Trust probe, right? You have JDBC probe. So different probes have different functionalities to acquire data from the devices. And also you do have Cisco probes, right? And the SNMP probe is actually having recognized as a NIFS, management protocol disk. So the network devices understand this language, management protocol disk. All is hold that is hold all the information regarding the device inside a NIFS file. It's a bundle of package file, which usually comes through the vendor for integration inside the network. So it could have different ports and different ports or different functionalities to acquire data from the devices. ProVGS is rules and lookup tables to categorize and add information to events. As a result, network data collected by the probes is normalized into a common alert format and then passed to the server AEL OB as display protocols. Right. So probes work with lookup tables, your properties file, rules file, right, and binary file, and configuration file. So all these files are dedicatedly comes when dedicatedly available when you install any probe in the system. When you install the probe, you find the dot probes file, props, dot alias rules file, then your config files, your nfig, and binary files. So all these files can help you to manage your probe efficiently and configure your probe to acquire the data. And finally, you get the data visible ultimately inside your AEL, the server, or with display protocol view that is called, right? Gateway. Yeah, so gateway, I already told you, like, gateways are interfaces to other products of network or third-party application that allow sharing of network level data. So gateway is kind of interface. So it acts as the interface between your internal open universe module, for example, that I told in the first slide. The data is pushed from your collection to aggregation and aggregation to display through your internal gateways of network that is called indirectional gateways or through bidirectional gateways. Now, dedicated application gateway, third-party application integration, you need to have dedicated gateways. For example, you want to integrate transitional with network, so it should have transitional gateway, right? Like a JDBC gateway to push JSON data to your or integrating properly to, for instance, Dynatrace, you are integrating to us. That should have a webhook or kind of specific protocol to use, and for that you might need your method of code for that. Like you are integrating your SolarWind with your cool targeting tool, so it can have the JDBC code installed. So all the third party applications we want to integrate with NetCool can have better this functionality, like integration on that. So you require dedicated flow and dedicated gateways for that, right? So gateways mean for that only. It's kind of interface. For example, multiple network of the service can share data using gateway to offer customers localizing and payload access. For example, local gateways. Right. So, internal gateways, like MS and bi-directional gateways, as I told you, that also act as your load balancing or payload facilities in the same way that other gateways does. Right. And in addition, event data can be exported through gateways to database, such as Oracle Database. Yeah. So, like internal gateway, I told you that pushing data from the object server to different object servers through its integrated gateways, ingestion gateways or directional gateways. Now, gateways, dedicated gateways, or for example, your JDBC gateway can be used to push data or from this server event data towards your database, RDBMS, for instance, Oracle or Sybase, for historical purpose or for troubleshooting to remedy or service node through remedy gateway or service node gateway, right? So, gateway functionality is that it's the interface between the application, central application, or between the server tool for integration. Desktop tools. Now, desktop tools are get installed automatically when you install the Omnibus core package. You'll get a lot of functionality within this tool, desktop tools, like conductor. It will help you to configure automation, the map editor, and make enable for you the filter and views, right? So the right hand side, this one. And the event list, the middle one. You can see all the information, the four threads in single sign in view. That is called event list AEL or WebView, like that one. Filter builder, view builder, you can see here. Through which you can make filters. For example, I want to see in AEL and make a view like XYZ. When I click on the XYZ, it should show me the all critical alerts pertaining to some particular region. So you can do the filter like that. You can create the filter like that. So make it view. Right? Make it view and display here. Like even viewer, you can make it XYZ and showcase all the critical alerts within specific region. You can also do that. And this one, the left one is example how to create filter inside the WebView. Right? So filter name and the SQL statements advanced. If you click on advanced, you can have SQL statements directly to make the filter. Or you can have a dedicated front-end facility to assign to any field for any value. Right? In that way also you can do the trigger filter. Administration tools. So this is also get installed available to you once you installed your Omnibus core package, right? Through this tool, administrator GUI tool, you can manage all your infra NetCool infrastructure module seamlessly. You can delete failures, you can delete you can log into multiple databases, you can log into object servers, I can correlate, make triggers, right? All these things you can do here. I can automate, you can write procedures, you can create users, you can create users view, you can assign ID and password to the users. So all the things you can do this emulator quickly. So this is made available to you once you installed your Omniverse Core package somewhere. So most of the items, most of the functionality you can get from the emulator tool by squeezing out and through your either command line interface or SQL interface, right? And this is NetCool WebView. This is the display layer that I told you in the first slide. Display layer keep hold of all the data, event data in single pane of glass format, right? Concentrated view. So you can watch all the alerts in one pane. So NetCool WebView gives you a web-based application that process network event information and agency data output to the users so that they can monitor events in their network environment. Event data is published from one or more data sources in real time so that operators can view pages that display this information in web browser, right? So this WebView we can prepare in such a way that it can hold, it can support a lot of data sources, including. So we have a wider facility and coverage to maintain different data sources, say maintain views of different data sources, or you can maintain filters of views, right, for the Azure requirement, or you can maintain your own infrastructure layer here, right? NetCool WebTop expands the event visualization and management capabilities of NetCool Omniverse by being both highly configured and remotely accessible through internet. Right. So this will be a DTC WebView portal. This portal can be available inside your internet. So all you can do is that you can hit in the browser and type in the URL that the WebView recognized, and it will be good to go for to monitor all this. Okay. And through NetCool, you can simultaneously connect to one or more of the servers, centralize all the information in one go, and one place you can view all the information. Right? The individuals can also view all the relevant alerts by logging to the data source or logging to the dedicated view that is made for them, right? For instance, commands and people. So you create filters and make views for them dedicatedly, they can log into the system, log into the NetCool WebView, and they can monitor it. And this is the slide where you can get to know, okay, what, how my alerts actually can be seen in the console. So this is a picture of it. This is a PHP event list. So all the alerts you can see how it looks like, right? This is kind of your major alerts, and this is your warning alerts, minor alerts, and this is warning alerts blue. Right? So this is kind of look and feel I have just captured from the NetCool Omniverse active event list view. So your views look like this, where all the alerts come and travel to one place considered view. Correct? And here is my slide finished. So I'm signing up for the day, and hope you like this video. And if you like this video, you can share as much as possible, and get me your comments and post me your thoughts on this video. I'll try to enhance more by your comments. So thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you. Bye bye.